welcome to the Board of Selectmen's meeting for Tuesday, January 10th. I ask everyone to please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everyone. I will entertain a motion to approve the expense warrant for 12/20/16, payroll warrant for 12/20/16, expense warrant for 12/27/16, withholding warrant for 12/31/16, payroll warrant for 1/3/17, expense warrant for 1/3/17, and expense warrant for 1/10/17.
I'll make that motion.
One second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
And entertain a motion to approve the selectmen minutes for 8/2/16, 8/5/16, 8/23/16, 10/18/16, executive session number 2.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Entertain a motion to acknowledge the minutes and reports from the Brookfield Emergency Squad for December 16 and the Advisory Committee for May 16th, 2016 and May 20th, 2016.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Announcements. Starting January 15th, permits for outdoor burning and brush and forest debris will be available. Permits will be issued until April 30th. To obtain a permit, please log in to C. The letters. What's that?
That's a hard one.
It's tough. C, the letter C, number 8, burn permits. So C8BURNPERMITS.com. Only call the dispatch office at 508-867-1066 between 7:30 a.m. and noon if you do not have internet access. Please, please do not call 911, the fire station, or the regular dispatch number. You do not need to go to the fire station. Mr. Wallinen, District 8 and Senator Ann Gobey will be holding office hours at the Brookfield Town Hall from 11 a.m. to noon, Wednesday, January 18th. All are welcome. Seniors and veterans are encouraged to apply for the Senior Tax Work-Off Program. Please call the Selectman's Office at 508-867-2930 at extension 10 for more information and application. Any other announcements? Hearing none, anybody wish to address the board this evening? Welcome, sir.
Welcome. First thing on my list is, why do we still have the bridge signs up on Quaybog Street when the bridge is open? It says closed, and we got detour signs going this way and that way.
Why
signs are still up? Yeah,
I haven't confirmed it, but my belief is that the town highway department doesn't want that much traffic on that road.
Yes, that's the reason.
But it's not good for the people out of town. They're going to go, you know, they says the bridge is closed, and they're going to, I mean, the detour signs aren't even properly in the right arrows.
I'm not opposed to it because, one, the bridge is open, and two, any more traffic on that could deter the bridge from being open. So I think it's a win-win for the town of Brookfield without getting us into a legal binding issue.
What's the legal binding issue?
The town wanted to just make it to local residents. I've argued that it can't be precluded just to town residents because it's Chapter 90 and the whole state, whole country can ride on it.
All right, I don't agree with it, but I mean, people coming through, if the bridge is open, they should be able to come through there.
Which they can.
They can.
Well, if they don't know that the bridge is open.
Like I told you.
Well, we're trying to stop a lot of the commuter traffic that was using it.
Okay. Number two, my question is, where do we stand with this highway police investigation into the highway department equipment disappearing and reappearing?
We received the report. I distributed it to the board, and we will discuss it once we've read the report.
When will that be, the next meeting?
I just distributed it today, so they'll get back to Karen and let me know when they're
available. When's your next meeting?
Well, we're going to set that today without talking to the board. I'm assuming 2 weeks from today. So more than likely that'll be when it's discussed, if it is even discussed.
Okay. And I don't know if Karen, I'm still trying to see what about, if there's any inventory from the last animal control officer?
David,
besides the cages?
I need to send along that email to her, and she is going to get back to you because she just asked me who Marie was because I gave her Marie's contact information, so she is working on that.
And what about, okay, what about, we're keeping dogs?
Are you talking about Eileen?
No, I'm talking about Sarah.
And what about capturing animals or dogs that get loose? Where are they going if someone loses their dog in town?
So she's leaving them where they are, and she's just tying them up and bringing food and water to them because there's no place to bring them right now.
Can you please check to see what we can do about that? Because
she's working on it. In fact, she was working with North Brookfield, and I don't know if she got a total no yet from the police department there. But Mike also was going to bring it up to see if she could move some dogs to the transfer station before they voted on that yet or not. But we're kind of on top of it. Just no decisions have been made. But I'll check with Sarah again.
Well, that just contradicts our belief from what we thought, so.
So you're looking into doing maybe something at the transfer? Like
they
used to in the old days?
I know Mike doesn't think everyone's going to go along with that.
Well, I know the Boy Scouts years ago cleared out the old town pen on, what's that, was it Foster Hill? They cleared it up.
But that's not really, no, I don't think that's for that, no. That was like we did it one time, I remember years ago, we had appropriated money to build a dog pound down at the landfill. And I don't know if it was ever started or if they transferred the money and used it for other funds.
So our town accountant might want to look into that, see if there's a line item for it.
Oh, this was quite many. I'd say even a good 10 years ago.
Well,
if
it was an article, it's still there.
Okay, so is somebody actually looking into getting something built for the...
Well, it's not
like they used to have at the transfer station. They had a nice thing down there at one time.
Well, she's going to report back to us, and we'll go from there. And in the meantime, we'll see if there's funds.
Nothing looks promising, so if anybody has any ideas, I'm sure she'd appreciate it.
Okay, I just don't want to see the dogs tied up in the winter and where they're found.
I don't want to see them.
Kind of silly, yeah. Doesn't sit well with me.
All right, thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else wish to address the board this evening?
Just a quick question. I want to follow up on concern about the bridge. The question should be, is the bridge safe for traffic?
It is.
Well then, why would we leave the signs up?
I mean, I didn't weigh in before, but the idea is that we're going to be repairing the bridge very, very soon.
Right.
We have the quotes and all those kinds of things. So to take the signs down and then to just turn around and put them back up again, that doesn't make sense to me. So that's my nickel.
It takes
nickel.
It takes a few screws to take the signs down?
Look, I'm just...
But the bridge is safe.
The bridge is safe to the one-lane traffic.
Mm-hmm. We want to keep the signs up.
Like I told you, I'm not pulling any punches. I haven't confirmed it. Okay. I would bet my house.
No, I'm just... It's a little confusing. It just doesn't make sense.
That they're up to deter traffic on that road.
As much as anything else.
But the bridge is safe.
The bridge is safe for the one-lane traffic.
So why do we want to deter traffic?
Because we can't have, you know, big vehicles going
because,
over there.
Nick.
No, it's one lane.
Because
it's just one
because
lane.
People aren't stopping. Mm-hmm. Yeah. People are going right through. Yeah. There's going to be a head-on collision. They're driving way too fast. And anything we can do to alleviate that situation, I think, is better for the town and for anybody that gets hurt on that road. We have sent the chief out and informed him to do more policing on that road. Linda,
there's stop signs on each side.
There is. But
people
are flying
stop.
Through it, and they're doing it at a high rate of speed. Yeah. It's one lane as opposed to two, and it's a pretty good corner.
No, okay, just want to make sure the bridge is safe.
So I'm not opposed to the sign staying up for that reason. Okay. Anybody else wish to address the board this evening? Hearing none. Agenda item number one. Mr. Martell, if you could come join us, please. I am going to entertain a motion to enter into executive session number one to discuss the reputation, character, physical condition, or mental health rather than the professional competence of an individual, or to discuss the discipline or dismissal of or complaints or charges against a public officer, employee, staff member, or individual. Mr. Martell, you have the right. Well, actually, first, do I have a motion to enter into?
I'll make that motion.
Do I have a second?
Second for discussion.
I will entertain discussion.
What are we doing?
What are we doing?
Yeah.
We're discussing Mr. Martell's purchase of a vehicle without the approval of the Board of Selectmen.
Did he have the right?
Did
he have the budget to do this? Or
no,
is there
he didn't. The Board of Selectmen has the budget, and there's policies set in place to do it. And that's part of the discussion this evening. Any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor? Come to our eye.
Lincoln, aye.
We need a roll call, Mr. Snyder.
Snyder, aye.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Martell, you have the ability to stay in open or to into executive in the Selectmen's office privately.
No, we're going to do an open, but that needs to be a discussion after this is over. But
in regards to what?
The executive session provision, but.
Let's have that discussion now.
Okay, I wasn't notified appropriately, but we all got work to do, so let's just get this over with.
No, I don't want to infringe upon your rights. Why do you state that you weren't notified?
I was supposed to be notified in writing along with the basis for it, and that didn't occur, so. But that's fine.
I sent an email with, at first I did reference exemption one, and then along with the usual form that we always use when we notify people, I did send a bad email. He did confirm that he received it, and he said that he wanted a specific reason that we were obligated to give him a specific reason why he was being called in. I checked with town council. She had me add another sentence to it, and I sent him a revised.
Was that done within 40
yes,
hours?
Yes, in fact, I even did it for my house. I did it to make sure it was done within 40 hours. I sent him a revised.
So you sent it to the same email on the
yes,
chain of emails?
Yes, and nothing kicked back. Are you saying you didn't get the second?
No, I'm saying it wasn't in writing. It was in an email form.
An email is in writing, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, town council knew that and didn't say that it was appropriate.
Okay. Any other complaints in regards to what's about to transpire?
No,
or
no.
The board have any issues with what's happening? Or? No, with the way that it was posted? And
no.
Okay. No.
All right, so Mr. Martell, if the minutes can reflect that it's chosen to stay in open session. It was brought to the board's attention that a vehicle was purchased without the board's approval. I have serious issues with that. We do have policies in place. We have a brand new policy and procedure, administrative finance policy in place. We have policies back from 2011, all were violated, and the warrant that was actually signed, which should have been signed by the Selectman's office and our procurement officer, was signed by the chief himself. With that said, Linda and Clarence, the floor is yours.
It's the same thing that Mr. Conpor just said. He said that we didn't give you permission to actually purchase a new vehicle. And if my memory is correct, when you purchased the black Ford you purchased that without permission, and we told you you shouldn't do it again without getting permission from the Board of Selectmen.
Which is correct.
And it seems to me that you seem to forget that we're the appointing authority here. And what makes you think that you don't have to tell us what your actions are going to be? Do you have an answer to that?
Well, I'd like to lay out the time frame, if I may. I just didn't know if you wanted to let Mr. Snyder speak first or.
Well, and second of all, I don't have any copy of any of these documents.
No, these are some things, questions of my own that I made.
Okay.
What would you like to see, Clarence?
I'd like to see that packet that you just sent.
This is the only one I have.
So. Yeah, I'm just going to pass it down so I can read it.
It was in the folder.
So did you answer that? You seem to think that you don't have to report to us with anything. It just seems that anything that ever comes up, it just seems that you go ahead and do it without authority from the Board of Selectmen.
Well, the issue at hand is the vehicle purchase itself.
Well, that goes along with it, too.
Yeah, let's let Clarence review that, then we'll move on.
Well, can I ask a question?
The gas is made, you love it.
Do you have a copy of these documents?
Not in hand. I believe I got them at some point. I don't recall.
All right. We've ever signed off on them. So you believe that you have these documents?
Somewhere, probably.
Okay.
So what, that's the new financial? Is that what you're
part of it. And plus we had implemented a policy when we shifted over to
These are the ones I think I looked at.
Less of finance. The first one is a policy we implemented. Linda, the one that's upside down is from 2011. That lays out exactly what happened.
I read these today and I was
That covers procurement. The other one covers purchases of equipment. The one that's upside down on the red folder.
Okay.
I'd actually have to review to see if I've got them or when if I received them, so.
I did check. It was sent out again on, I think it was May 26, 2016. Yes, there. And I sent it to you.
So I guess given these documents that you say you have, then what was the procedure that was used, or where do we stand?
I would guess I'd let Mr. Martel explain where he believes he's at. He's not at fault, and then we can articulate why I personally feel he's at fault and call for this executive session.
Okay.
Floor is yours, sir.
All right. The last annual town meeting, June of last year, money was put in that account. The reason stated for the public were to purchase a fire department vehicle and a police department vehicle. Discussion, the whole thing came about. We moved some money around to do it. At the end of that meeting, I approached the police chief, and I expressed to him to have him go ahead and proceed with his purchase first, as there was still some question about the total in the account and if anything else came up, and I felt that his need was actually greater at that time, so go ahead and get that all done, and when he was all done, then I'd proceed with mine. So that was June. He started the process somewhere in July for his vehicle. September 16th, I inquired as to who this chief procurement officer was. I was told who it was, and Karen just asked me if there was any, if I had any needs or any problems. And the issue was, as researching vehicles, if we lean towards going to a used vehicle, would require a RFQ or an RFP or some type of proposal written by the chief procurement officer. But at the time, the figures seemed to reflect that going with a new vehicle seemed better. So I told her that since we're going with a new vehicle, we wouldn't need to do that because it would be under state bid. And that was just acknowledged without any other question. The October department heads meeting, I stated that the new vehicle had been ordered. That was in attendance by Mr. Snyder. Nothing was said about anything.
You informed Mr. Snyder that a vehicle was being purchased?
I did at a department heads meeting.
And you didn't advise the board, Clarence?
I guess I did. I took minutes of that meeting. I don't have the minutes.
And I don't remember you even putting anything in. There wasn't anything in
there. There was nothing in there.
Nothing in
there. I don't remember ever hearing it.
No, because October, I just took a couple minutes. We do a lot of things over the late summer, just reviewing, testing, and training.
I'm really trying to be patient and let you speak and try to write notes down, but Clarence is saying he didn't say it. Linda's saying he didn't say it. Okay. Karen's saying he didn't say it.
Okay. Linda wasn't there.
I can go back over my notes. I didn't record it. What I tried to do at those employee meetings was to communicate those several hot topics.
That's a huge hot topic.
Yeah.
And that's something that wouldn't slip Mr. Snyder's mind.
I don't remember saying it in the minutes of the meeting that you did up for that.
All right, continue.
Okay. At some point after that, the police chief took possession of his vehicle. We had a conversation. I asked him about the vendor, the outfitter, and he had some good recommendations on who he used. And I asked him, I said, well, what process? Were there forms? Did you meet with the board? Did you have anything you needed to do with the board up until that point to get the vehicle? And he said no. He expressed he didn't meet with the board, that he didn't have anything to fill out for the board. He'd gone and ordered the vehicle and arranged to have it outfitted and gone from there.
But there was a difference in the process where he came back to us before he took possession. The car sat here.
Well, what he did is he actually, through Holly, approached the board through our administrative assistant / procurement officer, had her sign the warrant, made the board aware of the process, kept us in the loop, and then we purchased it.
Okay. All right.
Which is completely, totally separate from what this chief has done.
And we didn't even know anything about this.
On November 11th, the former cruiser, the 2000 LTD Crown Vic, failed its state inspection. Well, they didn't even go any further. It was deemed unsafe, so it was taken out. I don't know where it is. I produced something in writing. I sent it to the board just stating that vehicle was out of service.
And it was behind the building.
It's in your monthly notes, yeah.
And that you'd put it behind the building?
Yeah, it's back there for now. It's waiting to be disequipped, if that's a word. And there was a request that we, both the police department and the fire department, eventually be allowed to use it for training, because it really, it's not worthy of any repairs. And I believe the notation was in there also, that with the new vehicle was inbound within the next couple of months from that. I don't recall the language. I thought I would have done that, but. So where was I? The vehicle came in. The bill came in. Your administrative assistant was still out, so I asked Holly, I said, when the bill for the police chief's vehicle came in, what did you do with it? And she said she turned it into the selectman's office at that time, and the selectman's office had actually given it back to her to submit. So Holly said she submitted it at that point. The November month-end report, it does state that the other vehicle was taken out of service, and that the forestry truck would be used for that type of duty until the new vehicle came in.
So we got that document.
That part was in there. The biggest part was, I conferred with the police chief just in the overall topic, and we talked regularly. And I asked him, well, what procedure, what did you go through to do that? And he said, up until delivery, he'd done nothing.
So, are you done with your statement?
Yeah.
Okay. So a handful of times the chief has referenced the chief of police as his mentor. Mm-hmm. We're your boss, Peter.
Yeah.
Not once did you report to the Board of Selectmen your desire to purchase a vehicle, i.e. new or used. Okay. Several meetings we sat in this room and discussed the purchase of a vehicle. None of us was opposed to you buying a vehicle. I think everyone in this room said that we needed to go towards a used vehicle situation.
Mm-hmm.
To see it pass before our desk, once it was purchased, once it was at an outfitter's, to get detailed without any discussion with the Board of Selectmen, that represents the town of almost 3,000 people. That's a huge lack of trust.
I don't see that. I was conferring with Mike at the process he went through. I thought it was
again,
just...
Again, Michael is not your boss.
I realize that. Well, when did...
The policies are prior very clear that we've established.
Prior to
if his... anybody that you wanted to confer with would have been our policy books. And not even being a selectman in this town, I've sat in that crowd and watched you question policies and procedures that were set by the Board of Selectmen. You are very well versed on policies and procedures in this town.
Mm-hmm.
You are.
The financial one I haven't read completely through because a lot of it's not applicable to me, but...
Procurement is. A 2011 policy on establishment, on acquisition of property is. We had a citizen at our last meeting, at the annual town meeting, that really offended me because I really take seriously what I do for this town. And he stood before us and he said, and I don't know if I'm just insecure, and he was looking at the Board of Selectmen or the advisory committee as well, and stated that we were spending money like a bunch of drunken sailors. Do we remember this?
Oh,
and I was,
I very much do.
And I was offended.
I was probably as much, if not more, offended than you. So,
and I bit my lip. I didn't say anything.
Mm-hmm.
But we're going to talk about two issues on today's agenda. Purchasing a brand new vehicle for a part-time fire chief can only be seen as spending money like a drunken sailor.
No, I disagree.
Especially without the desire to communicate that purchase with the people that have to sign off on it. Okay. It's huge.
Well, if I can, you said you met with the police chief. At what point in the process did you meet with the police chief? Was it that one meeting where he asked permission to spend money on the vehicle?
It was that. I was in communication with him. I probably want to say around three times I was in communication with Mike in regards to the purchase of that vehicle.
Okay, but I mean the board.
And I brought it back to the board through Karen.
Okay. There wasn't a public aspect to that.
Holly brought the warrant in.
Yeah.
For Karen to sign, which she did. It's a selectman's expense account.
Mm-hmm.
You signed your own.
Yeah.
I didn't sign approval of it. I just signed
signed the warrant.
That I signed the voucher saying the vehicle had been received.
What gives you the right to do that?
The vehicle had been received. I was just attesting to that. I wasn't being...
I own two businesses, and I've really tried to talk myself off a cliff since Friday. And both of my businesses have equipment.
Mm-hmm.
And I just, I sat in my truck today, and I have my clipboard with me all the time. It always has my checkbooks in it. That's the equivalent of my guy at my driving school picking up that checkbook, or the guy that's in my truck picking up the checkbook, and either of them buying a brand new vehicle with my checkbook without me even having any process of that discussion or my approval to write a check from my checkbook. That's the equivalent to me. They'd be gone, done. It's unacceptable. Mm-hmm. Especially when we've sat in this room and talked about shifting towards a used vehicle.
Mm-hmm. Well, if I may, so public meeting-wise, the police chief met with the board.
What does this have to do with the police chief?
I'm following a process, a precedent, basically.
The precedent is our policies.
Okay, and if I may then, did the police chief follow the policies completely?
Me personally, I don't believe he did. That's one person's opinion.
Okay.
But it wasn't as egregious as what you do and why you're sitting before us.
Okay.
He kept this board in the loop of his whole process.
Okay.
You did this completely blind to the
board. I wasn't aware. I asked him what he went through, what he did with the board, and he said he didn't. So.
And I've spoke to him about what I would.
But
like
he
to
did.
See.
Did he do that after he had ordered it or beforehand?
Before he let us know what he was planning on doing.
Okay. See, he didn't express that to me. I just took him that he said we took it that the town expressed what the money was going toward, and he went presumably first.
And I spoke with you. I spoke with you after that vehicle was purchased and asked you where you were at.
Yeah.
You didn't state anything to me. You said you were still looking.
No,
I think you said you were going to wait.
I was waiting until the police chief's process was done.
How much money was left.
See where we were on that, yeah.
And that was it.
Yeah.
You don't see an issue with any of this?
I could have communicated more, but again, I was going based
more?
On...
More?
I was going based on a precedent.
What about at all?
So.
All right, I'm done.
Okay,
so
well...
So, Linda, it's your...
Well,
can chief. We address the new versus used part of it? You said they were...
That ship sailed, as far as I'm concerned. We're here because you purchased a brand new, and correct me if I'm wrong, was approximately $34,000 vehicle?
Yeah.
$33,314.75. $33,000 vehicle with $814. Almost a $34,000 vehicle, minus the outfitting of it and detailing of it, without even having one discussion with this board. That's what we're here about. Not about a used one now. So for this board's understanding, I've actually reached out to the dealership. They're possibly willing to take it back. Reached out to the detail company. They've stopped the process. They're not too far into it. I don't believe I'm overreacting. This is a huge deal.
The new vehicle was a better deal.
Peter, you didn't bring this to the board at all.
I know, but if we're talking issues, you said there are two separate issues. If we're done talking about one, I just want to move on to the other.
Wait, that ship sailed to have that discussion.
So the new vehicle was the better deal for the town. It was cheaper and just overall a better issue.
Linda?
One big problem I have with it was you went into the Selectmen's fleet account and you put a voucher in for it and you signed for it. You don't have any authority to go into that account. If anybody should have signed the voucher, it should have been Karen.
Karen wasn't here, and that's when I that's why I asked Holly what she did with the voucher, and she said she submitted it.
I was here when Karen wasn't here. I was around up here a lot. Mm-hmm. You could have discussed this with me. You didn't discuss this with any of us, and you went ahead and did it.
It really smells of deceit, Peter.
And,
it really
and
does.
And then another thing was, did you go out and get bids for this? Because you're supposed, that's another thing you're supposed to show the procurement officer, and that goes under Mass General law. You have to do this.
This was under a state procurement bid.
But still, you still have to show the procurement officer the bids that you got, and you go with the lowest one.
It was under state bid, so
I've been told that even though they're under state bids, that you have to find out if they deal with the town, because they might not... Mm-hmm. I know one of the cruisers that we bought years ago, we had to piggyback with another town and pay like a $100 fee.
Yes.
Because
that was the old Barnstable or Plymouth County thing. This was the same exact vendor that the police chief had used. That's one of the reasons I went with him, because he spoke very highly of them.
Linda?
And again, the new vehicle was a much better deal than any of the used options.
That's not the topic at hand, sir.
No, but it's worth mentioning, I think.
No, but I just can't believe that you did this, without informing any of us. it's like you were hiding it. And like I just said, I was here plenty enough time during the period Karen was out. You could have pulled me aside and you could have talked to me about it, but you didn't.
So I'd like to see your notes for the December report that you just had a moment ago.
Oh, that was a November one.
November one?
Yeah.
I don't remember seeing the document, so.
That's a November month end.
I think we acknowledged it about a month ago.
Okay, but clearly read the last line.
That it was taken out of commission?
No. Read the last line.
This vehicle.
And I keep, when I took the 2000 out of service, I submitted something in writing, but I didn't.
So for those that are listening, the last line says until the new Squad 2 is in service. We could get a new Squad 2 a year, 2 years, whatever.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to.
You understand that, correct?
I'm
really hoping you're playing devil's advocate because I'm there with you.
Yeah, that's all. There was a comment here, and had we seen it, or had I?
Because so far, I don't see anything that's defensible for this.
I don't consider that the purchase of a new vehicle, Squad 2.
It was a given. He was going to get a new vehicle.
Yeah.
But there's policies and procedures to do it.
I agree.
And to purchase a $34,000 vehicle, I want to throw up right now.
Yeah.
I really do, and I'm not exaggerating. Linda?
I'm just very upset by this thing, too. I just can't believe that you did this without knowledge. I mean, it just seems to me, you know, we're the appointing authority, and you're always going over our heads with something.
I'm not.
You're documented that you are.
Yeah.
You were suspended for it.
But that's a whole nother issue.
It's not an issue. Linda's making a statement that you're denying that there's physical proof of.
No, she's making a statement that I do it always. In 31 years of service as a department head of this town, I don't always do it.
I've been a department head
for 31 years. If I always did it, then that wouldn't be an issue.
And then another question I have, too, is, you know, You're part-time fire chief,
mm-hmm.
and now you'll also be using this for your other position too, which you're part-time firefighter, right, and paramedic.
No, I'm full-time in that position.
Yeah, I understand that, it's a slash. It's a firefighter paramedic.
Yeah.
So actually, my feeling is that you shouldn't. Do you have authority to use this vehicle for that position too, or just for your fire chief position?
Oh, very rarely.
Because those are two different positions. Fire chief is the one position,
mm-hmm.
and then the other one is your part-time firefighter and paramedic.
The best, very, very, very rarely would it ever be used on the ambulance side of it. It would be used for meetings and inspection. Inspections is the largest part.
But I've seen you out when you had all your other vehicles, you've been out and you've used that vehicle. I've even seen you out of town with any vehicle you've had. So you'd be using the new one for that job too.
Very rarely. I don't know which, you know, what occurrences you're citing, so I can't speak so specifically.
Well, I've seen even when you had with any vehicle you've had, Peter, I've seen you out of town with it.
Yeah.
And if it was supposed to be the fire vehicle, it should be used for fire chief things.
Mm-hmm.
And you're not acting as the fire chief during the day. You're acting in your other full-time position.
Right, but that full-time position includes any area of maintenance, inspections, meetings, so that's what it'd be used for.
No, I don't feel it should be.
Was that it, Linda?
Yeah, I had another issue too, but I don't know if...
Well, you brought up the use of the vehicle, so I guess I'll...
Okay, this is another issue. I noticed on the warrant of 12/27/2016 that you turned in a voucher on fire department expenses, and you had a bill for Molasses Hill Road And I noticed, and that's your personal property, your home, and the town accountant caught it and she crossed it out. So I'd like an explanation on this.
I made a mistake.
And why it happened.
I made a mistake.
Do you pay your, do you normally pay your personal bill at the same time that you're paying?
When the bill came, I picked up my mail that day. It ended up in a pile on my desk and just made a mistake and put it on there.
Well, I'm wondering if this happened before, because
No.
I don't think I would be having my personal bills mixed in with my work bills.
It wasn't my bills, it was my mail, National Grid stuff. I get two bills for fire and one bill for myself. And
now what, did they all come to the same address?
No, but I picked them up. I stopped at the post office, pick up my mail, come to work, pick up that mail.
But don't you have a box over here? Don't you have a box that's outside?
Yeah.
Linda, was the other two bills turned in?
Yes, at the same time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was that they were turned and Carrie caught it and she crossed it up.
So there are normally two fire department bills. Why did I get three on the same voucher?
Yeah.
Yeah, I made a mistake. I mean, the other thing, National Grid sometimes has a miscue on it. We've gotten late bills, recently, and statements and stuff. Yeah. Oh, I don't like the account number. I wouldn't know.
Peter.
Yeah.
Wow, my head's spinning.
That I made a mistake.
Wow. Anything else, Linda?
I'm wondering if my question is if this happened before. And if it wasn't noticed before by a previous town accountant, because right now the new town accountant, I have to say, she's very good and she picks up on anything that's not supposed to be on those vouchers.
Do you remember the word that I started this off with? Was trust. Mm-hmm. Wow. Is that it, Linda?
Yeah, that's it.
Clarence?
Nothing more.
I'm shaking.
Are we allowed to speak at all?
Absolutely not.
No. I wouldn't want to speak.
I'm wondering, another thing I'd like to say, I'm wondering if we should go back and check and see if anything else has been turned in on
this. We should, 100%. So, wow. So I'm glad we do have the accountant here. Carrie, do we have the ability to do a forensic audit within your department for those warrants?
It would take some time, I guess.
How much time are we looking? Off the top of your head.
Depending on
not holding you to anything.
A week or so.
Is this something I could go in maybe and look through?
It would involve pulling all the records from the previous warrants.
Which would help time-wise.
I'm sorry?
Which would help time-wise, having someone physically pulling warrants for you.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
I could set something up with you, Carrie, and you and I could go through them.
So one can of worms just literally exploded on this table, Clarence.
I made a mistake on that one. Fully admit it.
I can honestly say this is the first time that I've ever seen anything like that from him, so I cannot, say one way or the other what the history of it. I just happened to catch it.
It says, again, if we're able to make motions and the like, it suggests that suspension for the period of time it takes to review these warrants.
Suspension of the chief?
Yes.
Legally, it's not a suspension. From what I'm aware of, it'd be placed on administrative leave with pay.
Well, then that's the correct verbiage then. Mm-hmm.
So I would entertain a motion to place the fire chief on administrative leave with pay until an investigation and a hearing can be scheduled. Do you have that motion, Karen? Do I have a motion to that effect?
You have a motion.
Do I have a second?
I'll second it.
Any discussion? No. The discussion that I would like to have would be the next in command would take the responsibilities of the fire chief, and if unwilling to do so, it would go down the list of command until an individual accepts responsibility for the department. If that can be reflected in the minutes, any further discussion?
So who's next in command?
It would be Mr. Chafee. Any further discussion? Hearing none?
Not for me.
All in favor?
Aye.
Come to our eye.
Lincoln eye.
Cider eye.
Anything else you'd like to say, sir? You understand?
Again, if you want to if we want to talk about the used aspect of the cost benefit analysis, it's there.
Not at this time.
It was a cheaper deal.
Not at this time, but you are aware that you are placed on administrative leave?
As fire chief.
As fire chief.
Okay.
At this point, effective immediately. Okay. Any further discussion?
Is he still going to be able to do his other job?
He still has, unless someone wants to make a motion to take him off the capacity.
No, just as the fire chief. Okay.
All right. So I'll entertain a motion to adjourn the executive session at 6:41.
I'll make that motion.
Sorry.
Come to our eye.
Lincoln eye.
Snyder eye.
Thank you, sir.
Just while I've got you, can I just ask a completely unrelated question?
Yep.
Oh, actually, I don't have a statement now. The budget requests went out today. Are those being returned to you, to the advisory committee, or the account?
Advisory committee.
I believe we had that discussion privately, you and I.
Yeah, I know.
We clarified that you are turning it in to me.
Yeah.
So just so that we're all on the same page, it is coming to me.
Okay. All right.
And Peter, this is, and I'm glad Carrie said it, because this is an example that Linda's making of
what?
You had the discussion. I've had those discussions with you.
I know. Just the memo that came out didn't come from the account. It came from the advisory committee.
But you had a discussion with the accountant.
Right. And I just want to clarify, since the memo came out from the advisory committee, and she just said the budget.
Technically, it came out from me, because I sent it to you.
Oh, right. But it was, the letter itself was signed and created by the advisory committee.
We're done here, Peter.
I just want to clarify. It's going back to
you. If you'd like to talk to Carrie privately, you may do so. Thank you, sir.
No, I can't.
Item number two, signing of the Council of Aging State Grant Contract. I will entertain a motion to allow the chair to sign the contract to receive $7,790.
I'll make that motion.
Second. Do we have a second?
We couldn't hear it very
well. Any discussion? No. We're conducting. Carrie, can you just have a discussion? Thank you.
This is, I haven't got any budget papers yet, so it's supposed to be in a couple of days. So.
Thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. You want this now, Karen, or in the packet? Because it's got the envelope attached to it. Now? Item number three, Mr. Marlby has reached out to the chair to try to set a designee for negotiations with the Brookfield Teachers Association. Do you have any volunteers for that?
I did last year.
And I'm going to show you a contract that I have to administer that I received today. So
the argument is that you have the experience, Linda. Would you like to be a volunteer?
I suppose.
Thank you.
I did it last year.
So I'll entertain a motion to...
Thank you, Linda.
I'm going to learn how to negotiate contracts.
To appoint Ms. Lincoln as our liaison to the school committee contract.
So they'll get in touch with me when...
Once Karen sends it. Yeah, Deb will be in touch.
Thank
you. Do we have a motion for that? Do I have a motion for that?
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Unfortunately, we're going to have to pass over item number four because the deadline has passed. It was yesterday, so it's kind of a moot issue.
Okay.
Yep. Who? You know who's missing? Carol's missing.
It's always important. Item number five, we have a list of special use permit requests. I'll entertain a motion to, we'll do this all in one motion, to approve the South Pond for the Worcester County Bassers for 5/13/17. For Quabog Pond, Worcester County Bassers, 5/13/17. Quabog Pond for the Ice Holes, 4/23/17. Quabog Pond for the Northeast RI Bass, 5/21/17. Chicopee Bassin Association, Quabog Pond, 5/7/17. Quabog Pond, this always gets me, Happy Hookers Bass Club for 6/3/17. Quabog Pond for the New England Bassin Small Boat Kayak Trail, 6/10/17. Quabog Pond for Mass Bass Nation, 7/8/17. Quabog Pond for Nipmunk Bass, 7/23/17. Quabog Pond for ADA, 9/97/7/30/2017. Do you have a motion?
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion?
Initial away.
Any discussion? Hearing none?
They're out early this year.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Item number six, another issue that I addressed in executive session, the town kind of spending money like drunken sailors, as far as I'm concerned. It was brought to the attention of this board that a seasonal worker was still working in the wintertime. Made a call to Cindy. She stated that there was work to be done. There was $8,000 in the budget. I told her that I really didn't believe in it. Mulled it over, gave a call back, got a machine. Spoke to the machine, feeling I was speaking to Cindy, but Herb returned my call. I had asked him to put a hold on the employment of that seasonal worker until this board could discuss it. Clarence had weighed in on an email saying he was supportive of that individual working. Herb made the argument that he still wanted the person. It was basically a one-to-one vote, so I told him to call Linda, and if she agreed with Clarence, keep him. If she agreed with me, he's to stop until the next meeting. Linda agreed with Clarence. The seasonal worker was still permitted to work, and that's why we're here now for this discussion.
And I did have some discussion with Cindy over today. If you, I can tell you.
You're the dividing decisive vote, so.
I discussed it with her today, and she said the first seasonal worker that they had only worked for a month, mm-hmm. and they didn't have any time to rehire until September. And she said there would be enough funds for the worker to be paid through the end of the fiscal year. She says he has a specialty with small engine repair, and he's maintaining all of the mowers, weed whackers, and anything that has any kind of, you know, small engine on it.
So the ones that aren't being used right now.
Yeah, he's going over everything.
That should have been done in less than a week.
But she says there's quite a bit of different equipment with small motors that he's taking care of. And then another thing he's been doing down there too is he's doing the inventory for the Clean Water Act, which should have been done, she said, quite a while ago. And she said this is required by the state and has anything to do with drainage such as catch basins and manhole covers, etc. And
you realize we've been discussing that for 6 years.
But he's doing it now. I mean, I didn't know that we've been discussing that for six years.
We had a previous selectman that assisted in that. I think he got half of it done in a day. It's just something, to me, Linda, these are just excuses to keep a person, and this goes back to that citizen talking about spending money like drunken sailors. It was presented on the town floor for seasonal work, not until we run out of money. We could carry that money over for next year.
But I went back and I checked some minutes of the meetings, and we sat on August 23rd, and in the discussion of the seasonal worker, it said nothing about how long, excuse me, I had a little long laryngitis tonight. It said in the discussion of the seasonal worker, it said nothing about how long this person would work.
I think it was discussed on town floor that the seasonal worker was for mowing lawns. Mm-hmm. Lawns aren't being mowed in the wintertime.
Right. Yeah.
And I have no problem with him fixing lawnmowers and weed whackers, but there's only a certain amount of lawnmowers and weed whackers that the town possesses. You're not spending $8,000 in labor.
So the point, and I agree with you, Steve.
Yeah.
So the point was that we did have some issues in having employment through the summer, so stuff that got done by others that didn't get done, and there should be some makeup, I'll call it makeup time. Yeah. And that's what when I was asked the question, that's what I was considering. Is make up time to catch up so that the mowers are ready to go.
And I had no problem with that. I told that to Cindy.
Right. And so the other thing that came up or has come up in the midst of this is we didn't do as well as we should have done in taking care of Lewis Field through the summer. Just because
to be on the radar, the communication back and forth is that they're trying to pass it back to the rec committee.
There wants to be, first of all, there wants to be budget available from April, May to June to the end of the fiscal year. So a portion of those dollars need to be allocated for that period of time.
Which we have now.
Yeah, it's there. Yeah.
But if we continue to let this individual work to do.
And I think that the message from this board is if we've caught up, the work's been done, the mowers are ready. That
was a discussion we had 2 weeks ago, and she's just finding more stuff for him to do. We have three full-time employees down there, plus Cindy, that's doing the administrative
work.
And
so isn't that the message? The message is,
if the mowers are done and we're ready for May or April, then the seasonal worker is done. I think that's the message.
From what I'm aware, they're done.
I think he's done too, but I don't know that for fact.
But this is what our discussion I told you was that we had today, and she said this Clean Water Act, altogether we have 400 catch basins in the town, and this all has to be done with a GPS.
Yeah, and if
this has been going literally for 6 years.
Well, I didn't know that, because I don't
Nick,
have...
Nick went out on his bicycle and did almost half the town in a day. We have three guys down there that could sit in a truck while they're doing potholes or whatever and do this.
And the point is, if the work's done and complete, and that there is another way to do the
pothole thing. So I think the whole discussion is, do we have the desire to say, you know what, you have three guys down there, let them do that catch basin work that should have been done 6 years ago, that's been just dragging, and it's almost offensive to bring this up again?
I agree in the case of the catch basins. What I don't and I don't have an answer for, because I haven't asked the question, is are we ready for spring? If we're ready for spring, then the seasonal worker is done.
If we're ready for spring.
So what's the definition of ready?
Are the mowers ready to roll out in the spring? Are we gassed up and ready to go?
So do we want a motion to reflect that?
I think a direction to the highway superintendent from the chairman would be sufficient.
I gave that direction, and I was told that he wanted to keep them on.
Then I wanted to understand what those tasks are.
He was talking about making signs.
I didn't hear that. I heard that there was...
There's just always something there to do that, in my opinion, that three guys should be doing. And then, we had Krista down there for months, and she was sent back because Cindy said she was all caught up.
Well, and if we're all caught up with the seasonal worker-related tasks, then we're done.
Can we make that executive decision this evening, or how do we want to handle it?
I can stop in the morning.
But it's got to be taken care of tonight, because this dragged on for 2 weeks longer than I wanted it to.
Well, I don't know how long tonight's going to last.
Well, we could do it with a very decisive motion.
Oh, and what would be the motion?
Just off the top of my head, if all lawnmowers and weed whackers are tuned up.
Ready to go.
Obviously articulated a little bit better than that.
Exactly.
That the seasonal worker is no longer needed until the season of cutting lawns.
The season of spring.
I'll agree to that.
David? Yep. And for sake of time, we've already discussed everything, so...
Well, I want to make a point to that fact. The advisory board, we discussed this, and I asked you to put this on the agenda, so... I talked to... When I noticed the worker was still down there, before you're talking about time frame, I talked to the secretary, Cindy. I said, how long are you going to be using this seasonal worker? We all discussed this. You know, you say you're making up time. Well, we didn't hire him to fix lawnmowers and do stuff in-house. We hired him to cut lawns, paint lines, help put street signs up, during the good weather. Okay? That's one point. Number two, I asked Cindy, how long are you going to keep him? And she said, probably November 1st, as soon as we get the leaves picked up. Okay? That's long gone. The leaves were done by around November 15th. If I remember correctly, I was watching. We have, right now, with those four guys down there, 32 man hours per day down there, not counting the water guy.
The payroll warrant that I signed, I only saw 1 8-hour day for the seasonal worker.
Well, I've seen his truck down there every single day. So.
But have you checked the payroll warrant?
No, the last I was one, in today, I couldn't check it.
The last one I signed was for 8 hours.
Yeah, that's what Cindy said.
I'm going to check that because I've seen this vehicle. this vehicle is the same one that's been down there as a seasonal worker. So there's something askew here again. So you talk about 32 hours per day. That's 160 hours per week when they're not plowing snow. What are we all doing down there? This is wintertime. We hired this guy not for makeup, doing lawnmowers and in-house.
You're rehashing what we
discussed. No, but I want to make my point here to the town. This is why our taxes are high, okay? One of the reasons. It's one of the small puzzles, but it all adds up. This guy should have been gone 2 months ago, and you're still talking about it. I am appalled.
We're talking about it because there's a process, unfortunately, that we can't violate open meeting law.
Yeah, that's fine and dandy, too. But the thing is, in place, this should have been addressed back in November.
I didn't know he was there until you called me.
I didn't know he was there.
I never saw him on a warrant.
Well, that's not my job to tell you.
I never saw him on a warrant, Dave. That's what I look for.
He's there. Trust me.
8 hours he was.
He was.
That's right.
And that's what she said. Some weeks she said he will be there for about 8 hours.
And he is also plowing, if I recall. Yeah.
Correct, which is a separate line item.
Which is a separate.
We have separate guys to do plowing. It has nothing to do with a seasonal worker.
This individual was identified as the seasonal worker.
Well, he may help out. He can come back in. That's fine.
Yeah, but why we're not seeing a seasonal worker voucher is because he's doing other work there.
Well, how much snow are we plowing?
We're going to talk about that in a bit, too. I would suggest.
Yeah, I could say something on that, too. But I'm just making my point here is we're not the advisory board. There's some good people on that board, all of them, actually. They're knocking themselves out. We're trying to save the town money. We're trying to find out what is going on in this town. And this is one of the reasons. And I don't want to hear about makeup because the guy we had for a month, he got forced out down there, but by the way.
Well, we're not going there.
No, I know, but part of the puzzle this discussion.
As far as I'm concerned, the work got done during the summer, and that's what the position was set up for. There's no need to be down there now.
Okay, fine. So he's been down there two more months than we needed him. 32 man hours a day. That's a lot of work. What's getting done down
but
there?
But, Dave, we just confirm that it's not 32 hours a month.
Well, if they're not plowing.
For 2 weeks, there was one period of 8 hours.
Yeah. I'm going to check the paperwork because
We had that discussion a week ago and you still haven't checked it.
Yeah.
And Cindy also told me.
I will be checking it.
Sometimes, even when he was around doing the seasonal work, she said it was for, I guess, a 40-hour work week. And sometimes the most he ever put in was 20 because she says he has another job.
Really?
But the work still got done, and we're good. So I will entertain a motion to instruct the highway department to cease the employment of the seasonal worker as long as the maintenance of half a dozen mowers and weedwackers
that were ready to go for spring.
Yeah.
Which they should be.
So that's not really saying you're not really putting the doors down.
We are.
Well, they might pull something out of the back. Hey, we got another little old lawnmower we just found.
Maybe.
Next week it'd be another snowblower or weed whacker. I mean, you ought to just cut the line and say, hey, listen, enough is enough. My taxes are too high. These last tax bills, pissed.
Which I think we're doing.
Yeah.
So, entertain said motion.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
Nope.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Number 7, signing the Mass Historical Contract from UMass. Mr. Snyder, the floor is yours, sir.
I need your signature, and I was hopeful that Carol would be here, but I'll try to catch her tomorrow. Just to give you a graphic on the contract between the town and UMass Archaeology, just so that you can see it, Steve.
Oh, wow.
That's what I'll administer through the summer, and hopefully by September 17th we'll have a conclusion. What I would ask, Steve, is that you would sign two documents, one for UMass's records and one for ours.
And you have that?
I have that. They have signed. And what I will do is it's asking, Mass Historical is asking, I've got to return the top two pages to UMass. It's on the second page.
If you bear with me,
yeah,
so I can read it.
Yep. And it's two copies.
And you're okay with attachment A? That's what.
Pardon me?
It's stating the scope of services. You're okay with
it? That's that document. That document has been reviewed.
It meets everything that we need.
Yeah, and just so that you know, in the mail today in the Selectmen's office, I have a letter from Mass Historical suggesting I should give you this too.
Do we have the grant in hand?
Mm-hmm. We have the grant in hand.
Does he have to sign this too?
Yes, Steve, there are two places where Steve, one, the document Steve has on the second page.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so for Linda and the town, The contract that we're about to make a motion to sign is for $35,000, broken down into four phases of payment for the scope of work that Mr. Snyder has reviewed. Compensation is for $35,000. I believe that was a matching grant, and we're told that the grant is in possession.
Yep.
I will entertain a motion to allow the chair to sign.
I'll make that motion.
Second it.
Any discussion?
Well, I only see that what the process that we went through is that we received three bids. Those bids were reviewed by a team. That team agreed that UMass Archaeology should be the one awarded. That document that you see there was sent to Mass Historical. Mass Historical came back and said that they concurred with the town's process. Mm-hmm. Further, Mass Historical came back to us to the top two pages of the contract that you've just signed. They reviewed that. They approved that. That then was forwarded to UMass for their approval. They've agreed, as of today, I picked these up earlier today, for your signature.
Excellent. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And thank you, sir.
And what they're asking for Carol as yep. chairman, and yep. I'll catch Carol tomorrow to send these back. My fun summer.
Your fun summer.
It's actually a rewarding project.
Yes, it is.
Item number 8 is setting meeting dates. So basically we canceled last week because there were not too many items.
We have 17, which we're going to cancel and two acceptance meetings.
So I'd like to cancel January 17th, set a meeting for January 24th.
Okay.
So Jan 24?
Yeah.
February 7th.
Okay.
And February 21st.
February
actually,
20,
21st is during the school week vacation. Do we want to do that, or I'm okay with it? I'm worried about people that might want to attend, or
it's up to you.
21st.
It's up to you guys. What do you feel?
I don't have a problem with that.
No.
You okay with the 21st?
Mm-hmm.
Do we want to do March 2 or?
Yeah.
I might be leaving on the 7th of March, which would be the next date. Can we just hold off and just do these 2 months?
Yeah,
sure.
And then I'll know better. All right, so entertain a motion for January 24th, February 7th, and February 21st.
I make the motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Item number 9, I was approached by Mr. LaRocca. He would like to get back on the Conservation Commission.
We can use him.
I am absolutely beside myself for not observing a moment of silence.
I just thought of that myself.
For John.
For John. I just thought of it.
The town of Brookfield lost a very dear citizen. And
on December 26th.
The day after Christmas in the morning. And, mm-hmm. and for the family, I apologize for not observing a moment of silence for a really great man.
Good guy.
John was the best.
There were lots of people there.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable man, and from the bottom of my heart, I apologize for not. I want to cry for not observing a moment of silence. And,
well, it's
and
not too late now.
Take a minute.
If nobody's opposed and it's at your discretion, ask everyone mm-hmm. to please rise for a moment of silence. Thank you, everyone.
Okay.
And God bless his family. I entertain a motion to appoint Mr. LaRocca to the Conservation Commission.
I'll make the motion.
To expire June 30th, 2020. Do we have a second?
Yep.
Yep.
Discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Item number 10, we actually have two individuals interested in taking advantage of our senior tax program. I will entertain a motion to allow Miss Plum, or Madame Plum.
Yes.
Madame Plum.
And I don't see a printed name here, and I can't
Annette
read that signature.
But Mary looked at it this morning. What's Annette's last name? I don't say.
Yes. It looks like an L.
Lanzilli? Is that how you
say it? We apologize for that.
I think that's how you say it.
Annette
Lazzilli. Lazzilli.
Yeah, Lazzilli.
So I'll entertain a motion for mm-hmm. both women.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Clarence just requires
yep.
signature. Item number 11, wage authorization, couple late arrivals. Entertain a motion to approve the wage authorization for $12 an hour for Sean Edgert.
I can't make it because I signed it for the chairman.
Okay, so I'll make the motion.
I will second. And all in favor?
Aye.
And I will entertain a motion for wage authorization for $11 an hour for George Hurdle for the transfer station. Mr. Snyder?
I can make that motion.
I'll second. All in favor?
Aye.
Under other, coming from the Highway Department, Mr. Chafee has been asked to notify the Selectmen that the balance in the ice and snow account as of today, which was January 10th, $30,312.19, approximately 10,000 outstanding bills in this week's payroll. It seemed to be wise to start the process and allow deficit spending of snow and ice. As far as I'm concerned, bills do get paid without a vote. So I would like to have a number in front of me before I approve deficit spending, and hopefully that's good karma for a better winter. Any discussion on that?
No.
Hearing none, a few forms of correspondence. DCR is pleased to announce that the application for a 2016 Volunteer Fire Assistance Program has been accepted for the amount of $1,975. There is a time limitation on the implementation of that. Clark University, Karen, has this gone out to our employees in town?
No, not yet.
Can you please send this out? Okay. They're pleased to announce that they are offering a 30% tuition waiver for an individual employed by the municipality. It's actually something that I've always thought of getting my master's. I might actually take up.
I did it once, Steve. Good idea.
For Clark?
Not for masters. I finished at Whoopi, but yeah.
You got a master's?
Yeah, absolutely.
I'd like to do like poli sci or something like that. I was going to minor in it, but I didn't see a reason for it.
Go for it.
I'll come knocking on your door for a donation.
Not a problem.
The other 70%. Mass DOT has informed the Highway Department of the bridge inspections. This is in our office for anyone that wishes to take a look at this. We do have a thank you letter to the Highway Department from, I believe it's Mr. and Mrs. Moulton of 82 Island Road, thanking them very much for watching over the town roadways, appreciating their hard work and their dedication in keeping the streets clear of snow and brush. They thank them for keeping our streets safe and wish you and your family a very Merry Christmas and a Happy Hanukkah. Very nice. Thank you. Through the Highway Department, thank you. Charter Communication is changing the lineups once again. I believe it is
777 doesn't work, let me tell you.
It is accessible through their website at the Selectman's office as well if you don't have that access. And they are changing their rates, basically going up about $2 to $3 for each service.
For each service?
Well, the tiers, basic TV, TV Select, expanded TV. 51 to 53, 62 cents. Public access fee, 62 cents to 42 cents. So leave that one with a good note and close that quickly. Any other business before the board this evening?
I've got two. Employee meetings. We kind of stumbled in November and December because of timing and whatnot. Contrary to what was discussed earlier, I thought we were making some progress.
Yes, I thought we were too.
And I would like to have agreement that we get back on that roll.
I would too. I think they're important to have.
At least we'll get some.
I disagree.
I understand.
And I don't need to go into any more detail.
That's right.
But God bless you for your pursuit trying to make them productive.
On behalf of Linda and I, Karen, could you reach out and notify and then put Linda and I on a rotation.
Last Tuesday of this month, okay.
And a rotation.
Do you want to do the first one?
Doesn't matter.
Yeah, you can do the first one, then I'll do the second one.
Yeah. So what? Okay, so last Tuesday of the month.
Make sure you take better notes. You roll my eyes as well, thank you.
You got that. I'm going to do some checking of those notes.
You're not going to find anything. I bet you $100.
Yeah.
And that's sad. It is. But a discussion for another day.
And I had a second.
that at our last meeting, there was some discussion on the definitions of a municipal employee or town employee, and that I provided, based on feedback from town council, that definition. And so Karen has forwarded that around to the different employees, and I wanted to make sure that Mr. Holcraft had a copy of that definition. And I provide the Board of Selectmen with a copy of the letter that I would like to present Mr. Holcraft.
Is this on letterhead from the town?
Yep, that's why I'm asking for your permission.
It's coming from you. I have no problem with it. It's just correspondence to Mr. Holcraft. We still have not received our...
What is it?
The definition of a municipal employee.
We still have not received our...
She probably have it ready for... She was on vacation, yep. Now she's sick.
Yeah, we actually, just so we're all clear, we actually had two inquiries. Herb had filed an inquiry in November, and I filed at our last meeting.
I've had a discussion with Michelle, and I'm not going to burst the bubble, but no. Once she makes a report and findings, yeah, well, she's definitely on top of it.
Yep.
Any other business before the board? Entertain a motion to adjourn?
I'll make that motion.
I'll second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, everyone.